Do we have an Edie? Here you go, Edie. Yeah. Thank you, and Merry Christmas. Let's give her a round of applause. As for the rest of you, sit back and relax and enjoy our Christmas card to you. May peace and love surround you at Christmas time and all the whole year through. I'm staring out a window at a softly falling snow that dances in the early morning light. I got my guitar right beside me, strumming a beautiful sound, watching it coming down. Instead of letting the postman bring it, I decided I'd rather sing it, especially for you. For you, to you and all your family, your neighbors and your friends. May all your days be happy with the joy that never ends. May peace and love surround you at Christmas time and all. Job in the world, delivering messages of love, hope, and joy. Oh gosh, look at that. The time is slipping away from me, and I still have all these cards to deliver. Wait a minute. Do you think you can help me out? Oh, come on. Do you think you can help me out? Whoa, wonderful. Let's get going. Our first stop today is to the house of Patrick, the son of Mr. and Mrs. Green. Patrick is away at college, and his sweet mother writes him a couple times a week, so this is one of my frequent stops. Hey, Pat, I have your weekly letter from your mom.
Oh, great. Let's see what she has to say. Dear son, we're having everyone over for a big family dinner the night you get home from school. I've already begun decorating the house. We put up the tree today. It's a big one. It sure is starting to look a lot like Christmas around here. See you soon. Love, Mom. Oh, I'm so excited. My mom has the best decorations.
Well, who's to say you can't get in the holiday spirit yourself? I mean, this place could use some sprucing up. Ladies?
It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas everywhere you go. Take a look at the five and ten, glistening once again, with candy canes and silver lanes aglow. It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas. Toys in every store. But the prettiest sight to see is the holly that will be on your own front door. A pair of hop-along boots and a pistol that shoots is the wish of Bonnie and Ben. Dolls that will talk and will phone for a walk is the hope of Dennis and Jen. And Mom and Dad can hardly wait for school to start again.
It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas everywhere you go.
There's a tree in the Grand Hotel, one in the park as well. The sturdy kind that doesn't mind the snow.
It's beginning to look
Christmas.
Christmas, Christmas.
Well, that sure spruced things up a bit. Let's see who we have next. Ah, Cameron. Cameron is expecting a Christmas card from his long-distance girlfriend, Beverly. A delivery for Cameron Bates.
Oh, thank you. Let's see. Dear Cameron, I hope all is well. I've been talking to my parents a lot lately, and they've advised me that it is time for me to settle down and get serious. My parents think I should get this done before all the focus is on Christmas. The fact of the matter is, we have been dating for the past 11 years, and you still haven't proposed. Therefore, I am breaking up with you. I'm sorry. Happy holidays, Beverly. She broke up with me. With me. I mean, gosh, marriage? I told her I would think about it.
Well, you've been thinking long enough. And Cameron, you realized too late.
Let's see who our next stop is. Grandma Parks. Grandma doesn't venture very far from the rocking chair these days. A delivery for Grandma Parks. A delivery for Grandma Parks. A delivery for Grandma Parks.
I heard you, honey. There's no need to yell. Don't dilly-dally. See what you got there in your hand.
Looks like it's a letter from Martha Snipes from Clearwater, Florida.
Oh, Margaret, we used to have the best time performing together at Radio City. Boy, were we a hit!
Okay, ma'am. I'm sure you were. All right, you have a great day, and Merry Christmas!
What a nice young man. Now let's see. Dear Carolyn, it's that time of year again when I start reminiscing about the shows we used to be in. Every time I hear Christmas tunes on the radio, I think of you. After all, there was no greater time I had performing than with you at Radio City. Happy New Year, Margaret. Oh, those days with Margaret were such a dream.
List. Love, Billy. Well, isn't that sweet? Let's look at this list here. Oh, my goodness. It's gonna take me a little while to get through this list. And while I get to work, I'll leave you with a little treat. Performing one of my holiday favorites live on the air, we have the famous Holland Sisters!
Here comes Santa Claus, here comes Santa Claus, right down Santa Claus Lane. Vixen and Blitzen, all his reindeers, pulling all the reins. Bells are ringing, children singing, all is merry and bright. Hang your stockings and say your prayers, cause Santa Claus comes tonight. Here comes Santa Claus, here comes Santa Claus, right down Santa Claus Lane. He's got a badass filled with toys for boys and girls again.
Sunset strip.
Right around the block. Come on, follow me. We made it. And it looks like they're having a holiday get-together. A delivery for Trevor Sparks.
Oh, that's me. Thank you. Oh, it looks like a letter for my grandparents. Let's see. Dear Trevor, happy holidays. Hope you're making good marks in school and eating well. You know there's always a piece of warm sweet potato pie over at Grandma's for you, just in case you stop by. Here's a check for $5. Yes, I know. Grandpa decided we're gonna spoil you a little this year, but don't go too crazy. We love you, Grandma and Grandpa. I love you so much. Thank you for giving this to me.
You're very welcome. Well, you guys have a great day and enjoy the rest of your party.
Oh, well, why don't you stay inside and get out of the cold?
A little cold won't bother me. Besides, I still have a few cards to deliver before Christmas Eve. But thank you for your holiday hospitality.
Of course. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas. Alexandra Berry.
That's me!
Oh my gosh, that's so exciting. What does it say?
Dear Alexandra, you mean so much to me. I can't imagine my life without you in it to make me smile. No one gets me the way you do. I know we've been best friends for 5 years now, but I guess I'm writing to find out if you feel anything more. Yours always, Andrew.
There's no greater present than hearing someone say, I love you.
You're right. This is better than any present under any tree.